Hi everyone, this is Jessica Lodato from the Rye Youth Council, and today I'm coming from my home to yours to talk a little bit about a personal experience we had with modeling, mediating, and timeouts. So on Sunday, we were getting ready to have our Easter dinner, and we chose to do something a little different this year. We chose to barbecue, play games, ride bikes, all quarantine fun kind of stuff, keeping socially distanced to ourselves. And our story starts with Gregory.
So it's Easter day, sunny outside, we're gonna light up the grill, have a barbecue, and I fancy myself a griller, so I decide to make a steak with a fun honey teriyaki marinade that I was going to prepare myself. So, not the first time I've done this, I'm experienced with marinades. So I start pouring this very, very teriyaki into the marinade bag, and as smart as I am, decide to set the open bag of marinade on the table like this, and it begins to spill down the cabinet here and down me into my clothes. And so I hadn't eaten much that day because I was saving my appetite for the barbecue. I'm a little hungry, and I get very frustrated because this is not what I wanted to happen.
Now, mind you, Mom is dying inside because I'm watching him have the situation happen, watching it drip down his favorite shirt, down my cabinets, into the pots and pans, and I want to be like, ah! But I step back because I noticed something. As he was losing his patience, he was acting just like me when I lose my patience in these situations. Tell them what you did.
So, took a deep breath, went upstairs to get all cleaned up. Mom here said that she would take care of the mess, so thank you very much for that. And, you know, she cleaned it up. I got re-prepared, we came back down, and the show went on.
The truth was, though, while he was upstairs and I was cleaning up teriyaki sauce sticky all over the floor and seeping into my cabinets, I had to say to myself, as he was losing his patience with all of us and getting upset, especially at his younger brother, who simply wanted to melt his chocolate for his dessert.
Yeah, I was making a cake and I was going to melt some chocolate icing to make like a fudge.
Okay, and kept telling him to get out of the way and losing his patience with all of us, I had to stop and realize that he actually saw that behavior for me, because when those little misfits things happen in my kitchen, I get anxious and annoyed and I start getting short with people. So I had to think about, while he was upstairs taking his time out and changing his clothes and composing himself, what I was gonna say to him when he got downstairs. Because I wanted to be empathetic. I understood the idea of why he was frustrated, and I also had a mirror. This is what I look like when I get that way, and this is how I talk to people. And as an adult, it's not okay either. So then he came downstairs, and what did you tell us then?
I straight out apologized because for my temper. Don't make excuses. Just say you're sorry.
And what I loved about this moment for us was that I was able to look at Gregory and say, I understand how you felt, and I know I do the same thing, and I've actually learned something from you today. And I appreciate you apologizing. Not only apologizing without making excuses, but then doing a special shout out to his younger brother to say to him, like, I realize my behavior affected you. And I made sure that when he came downstairs, I pointed that out, because although he was apologetic, I don't know if he thought about everybody in the room. And I think Christian learned something too. What did you learn?
That I need to have a lot more patience.
Well, I think that maybe if we're making something for dessert and dinner's going on, maybe the icing could wait till the next time.
Okay.
Anyway, for our home to yours, things happen, squabbles and tiffs, but we work them out. And the more we see our reflection of ourselves and our kids and have those moments where we can talk together, we all grow. And it's such a great experience. I'm grateful for you guys.
Yeah, grateful.
And I'm grateful for all of you. Have a great day.